Okay, definitely been waiting for this stuff to show up. What's in here? Big hole ring time. So we ordered two of these unibilt rings. One for the cab, one for the 36 inch bunk. We got one gasket and bag of huck rivets. Getting it mocked up here, trying to get it straight right where I want it. Clamp it down, mark it, and then we'll cut it. Okay, we got to cut out step one. I got to see about fitting the ring in there. Well, it was fun hacking out. Lots of pieces coming out. This is gonna be hard to see the light out there. I'm just gonna have to figure out if I'm gonna need to cut this up more or not for the bracket to fit around it. And same thing about this corner brace here. And then we've got this lower brace here. So I'm just gonna have to grab the ring, slide it, fit it in here, which would be interesting. But see how it fits around that upper brace. So if it fits, let's just see if it's upside down. I don't know if those are gonna fit right in here or not, but we'll find out shortly.
Oh boy. Does it fit through the door?
Barely fits through the door. Oh, there we go. It's in the cab. No, I got this in here backwards. Oh, come on, man. Backwards. There we go. Just to give you an idea what I'm really fighting here. I can't go straight back. Right here, my throttle pole. So for anybody watching this that decides to do unibilt conversion on an older pre-unibilt cab, these are some things you're gonna have to think about on fitment. You're gonna have to trim these. Trim this guy here, this one, and this extra lip in the floor here. Not sure yet. I'm gonna have to trim that.
Kind of rethinking my approach here. I'm putting in this ring on the inside of this cab.
So I was thinking I was just gonna be able to trim everything and shove this in here. I know it's dark in here, but this ring, it is bigger on this back than this inside one. And I've got to get it around this one, this bracket, and this bracket.
So there's rivets just holding these guys in.
And this outer stack piece. So I'm kind of thinking I grind all the rivets and take this one and this one out. Same thing on that side. I don't know about this guy yet. What holds it up here? I know the horn,
but even then, if I can get it underneath that one, that might not be too bad.
But I gotta know how much to trim this up, because I want it to sit in this channel. It should sit in front of this. I'm half tempted to go peel back the boot in the other truck and see how that looks.
But if I take these guys out, I can get this ring flush against this back wall and then put these in so they fit and trim them so they fit inside this channel. And having a feeling that might be a little bit more work, but the better way to go. I'm working on fitting in the big hole ring on the inside of the cab, trimming to make it fit. Needs to be moved over a little bit. So I had to trim this bracket. That's where the seat belt originally was. And I trimmed these guys. I think I've got them where I wanted them so that they fit down inside this channel so I can get two rivets through. So that's these support on here. So my plan is to have it pushed up in there and then push it against the back wall. So a few things in my way. Like these for the seat belts. So I had to reach under, take those out. Fun little trick. Those fit inside perfectly in a 1-inch socket. So we use those, get those out. And I think I'm gonna cut this off so that, what are we catching on now? Anyhow, it's catching on something. But so that I can just slide this right back and against this wall here to rivet it on. Plus, I want to be able to get to the bottom here for the rivets through here. Trim this bracket so that it fits down in this channel. So we can be able to drill these rivet holes, will come through and it'll support this brace here to this back brace. So it'll give me some support in the back of the cab. But in order to get this ring in, it needs to go up in here and then against the wall. So, but with those seatbelt rings out, mounting rings, and this thing, and I think we'll be able to shove it into the back here. That piece on the floor trimmed up, I'll grind that down a little smoother, but so I can get the bottom of the ring smooth against the cab. Just about fit up in there. A little spot in the trim. But to wrap up this video and part one today, I got the ring mounted in and all riveted. It's all through along the bottom and top. I took my work light off in here. Turn the camera up. What I did manage to do, I got one started and I busted a drill bit, so I'll come back to it. But I'm gonna get two rivets through this bracket here. It comes along the top of the cab through the ring. So these will be riveted together and mounted. So that support I like. And then I'm gonna trim this support here and rivet that back into the cab. And my big hole framework will be done. Interior, till later date. So then I'll be moving on to doing the big hole and the 36-inch bunk. I'm thinking to end this one. It's part one on the unibilt. Not unibilt. This is not a unibilt. This is just a big hole conversion. I'm just gonna clear it up real quick. If I was doing a unibilt, I would be putting in the brackets up here and down here to mount the sleeper to the cab. I am not doing that. The sleeper is gonna get solid mounted on the frame. Choosing not to do air ride on this truck. On the cab, I've got low air leaf on the chassis, and if the store ride's rough, we'll just air ride the front. I also did some looking and digging around, and I have to change a lot of bracketry along the top of the door and the cab to support that sleeper mount. I don't know on the bottom, so we're just gonna go simple. The big hole conversion was all just for that leg room. I'm 6'3". That's kind of important to me, so.